Welcome to dbForge Source Control Tutorials. In this video, we will show you how to create a local Git repository and then link your SQL Server database to it with the help of Source Control. Now let's get started with the prerequisites. First of all, dbForge Source Control connects to Git using the standard Git client for Windows, which you need to download, install, and sign into with your Git account. Secondly, you'll need to create a local Git repository and then clone it because Source Control doesn't work with either local or remote repositories directly, only through a clone. In a moment, we'll show you how it's done. Third, you'll need SQL Server Management Studio with dbForge Source Control integrated into it. Source Control can be downloaded from our official website for a free 30-day trial as part of a bundle called SQL Tools. Now let's see how to set up a local Git repository. First, you need to create two empty folders on your computer. The first one is where your main local repository will be stored. The second is the folder that your main repository will be cloned to. Then, start the Windows command prompt and navigate to the first empty folder you've just created. After that, type the command to initialize the main repository. Note that the bear flag makes a repository that doesn't have a working directory, making it impossible to edit files and commit changes in that repository. In other words, you create a bare repository to push and pull from, but you never directly commit to it. Next, you need to navigate to the second folder. And clone your local repository using the corresponding git clone command that contains the path to the main repository that you've initialized earlier. Pay attention to the dot at the end of the command. Make sure you place it there to avoid creating an extra subfolder. Now, there are only two commands left to execute. The first one is the command that makes an initial commit. Note the allow empty flag. It allows you to create this commit without making any code changes. The second command is git push, which finally pushes the changes to your newly created repository. That's it. Now let's get down to linking your database to Git with the help of dbForge Source Control. Open SSMS and establish a connection. After that, find the required database in Object Explorer, right-click it, find Source Control in the shortcut menu, and click Link Database to Source Control to open the wizard. Next, on the Link tab, click the plus icon in the Source Control Repository field. In the Source Control Repository Properties dialog, select Git from the Source Control System dropdown list. Then, in the Repository Folder field, enter the path to the folder containing the clone of your local Git repository. Make sure to specify the path to the clone, not the original local repository. Optionally, if you need to rename your repository folder, you can do it in the repository name field. Also note that you can click Test to make sure the connection will be established properly. After that, click OK and select the preferred database development model, dedicated or shared. The difference between them is rather simple. In the dedicated model, each developer works on their own local copy of the database and later commits changes to a centralized repository. In the shared model, each developer works on the same database and the same centralized repository. Once you make sure everything is correct, click Link. If your database has been linked to Source Control successfully, you will see a corresponding icon next to it in Object Explorer. Finally, since your repository is empty, it has to be filled. To do that, you need to make an initial commit. Go to Local Changes. Select the checkboxes next to the objects and static data that you want to commit. Enter your comment and click Commit. Now, you're all set to version control your database, and the integrated Source Control Manager will be your best assistant. With its help, you will be able to commit and revert changes, add comments to your commits, get the latest changes from the repository, resolve conflicts, and view the detailed history of changes. Feel free to check further videos on our channel to learn how it's done in detail. Ready to try it all yourself? Simply download a free 30-day trial of dbForge SQL Tools, a bundle of SQL Server tools and SSMS add-ins that includes Source Control. Alternatively, you can get the same functionality in dbForge Studio for SQL Server, our flagship IDE for database development, management, and administration. It is also available for the same free 30-day trial, so don't hesitate to check it in action as well. That's it. Like, if you've enjoyed the video, share your thoughts in the comments section below and subscribe to our channel to get the latest database tutorials. Thank you for watching.